What's going on, you guys? It's Cody Steck, your Utah realtor. We're back with another video. Today, we're going to be talking a little bit about the differences between Salt Lake County and Utah County. I'm going to be exploring everything from the population to jobs, schools, the religion, the culture. We're going to be looking at all dynamics from these two counties. It's going to help you make the right decision to know whether you should move to Salt Lake or to Utah County when you do end up making that move here. When you do make that move, make sure to get in touch with me. Call me, text me, or email me. I'd love to help in your transition to moving here to the Wasatch Front, and I'd love to talk to you a little bit more about the type of home and lifestyle that's best gonna fit your needs when you make that move here. I love it when you guys reach out, and I can't wait to hear from you. So let's jump right into this. I don't wanna waste any more time. We're gonna talk first a little bit about the population. So when it comes to the population between these two counties, you're gonna see a massive difference in how they currently sit, as well as what the potential future growth is going to be between the two different counties. I recently did a video that I'll link to right up here, over here, maybe, I don't know where it's gonna be. I'm gonna link to it, and it will show you a little bit about how the population in Utah is going to increase overall. I went super in depth on how that population's going to increase, but for the sake of this video, I just wanna talk about current population and the future population really quick. Right now, Salt Lake County is sitting at about 1.1 million, and it's expected to grow to roughly 1.5 million by the year 2050. That's 30 years from now. Utah County is a different story though. It's drastically different. Right now, they're sitting at just 600,000 people, but over the next 30 years, it's expected to more than double up to 1.3 million people. So Utah County is gonna have almost as many people as Salt Lake County, and it's gonna be a huge change for the state here. You're gonna see a lot of growth happening in areas like Eagle Mountain, Saratoga Springs, and further down south, you know, closer to Spanish Fork, Springville, Mapleton. That's where a lot of the free land is, and that's where a lot of the growth is going to happen in these areas. So next on our list, let's talk a little bit about culture. Salt Lake County is gonna be a little bit unique. Politically, you're gonna find that it typically leans a little bit more to the blue side. The demographic is also younger, and you're gonna find a, you know, more hip, walkable, type of lifestyle that you're finding in a lot of big cities right now. Once you get outside of the downtown area though, it does lean more red politically, and you're gonna find more families, you're gonna find older couples, you're just gonna find a demographic that generally leans a little bit older. I think when you're talking about the downtown area, this is close to the University of Utah, so that's why you'll get that there. But that's not to say that you're gonna find all walks of life in every single area, right? This is just kind of my perception of the area as a whole. You're also gonna find that people in Salt Lake County, and probably just the state overall, we love animals, especially when it comes to dogs. You've got a lot of dog parks. People love to take dogs up into the canyons, go hiking with them, and just have a blast with their animals. You're also gonna find in Salt Lake County that a lot of people here love to do things outdoors. You've got great access to the Wasatch Mountains. It's super easy to get to, especially if you're on the east side. So a lot of people here love to ski. They love to go boating, fishing, climbing. I mean, there's so many outdoor activities, and you'll find that a lot of people here in Salt Lake County love to do those things. Utah County is gonna be much of the same. People love going outdoors. They love animals there, but you're also gonna find typically more families. You're gonna find a younger demographic, and you're gonna find more working professionals in this area. Now, I wanna talk about jobs a little bit later on in the video. So if you're looking at jobs and where, you know, the most job opportunities are, make sure to stay tuned and watch for that section. Just to touch on that briefly, Utah County does have a very high percentage of white collar workers. And I'll say that there is a big college and university presence, especially in Orem and Provo, because you have two universities there. You've got Utah Valley University and Brigham Young University. So if you're in these areas, you're gonna find a lot of people in their, you know, early 20s. They're gonna have a younger demographic there. But once you get outside of that, tons of families, tons of kids. Now let's talk a little bit about religion. I just wanna give you a brief overview of how the religion is here and what you can really expect. So to cover that, I am going to mention that the state as a whole is roughly 73% Christian, 22% unaffiliated, meaning they could be atheist or agnostic or just not affiliated with any type of religion. And then you're gonna find typically 1% or less of other religions such as Buddhism, Islam, Hinduism, etc. Now that we have that out of the way, the biggest question you're probably asking is, well, what about the Mormons, right? Salt Lake County roughly sits at about 50% Mormon. It is gonna be a little bit higher in the southern end of the county, whereas in the downtown area, it's gonna be much lower, probably in the 25 to 35% in the downtown area. But the county as a whole is 50% for Salt Lake. Utah County is at 80% right now, and it has actually gone up a little bit recently, but I'm expecting that number to go down drastically over the next 5 to 10 years when many people such as yourself may be moving to the area who may not be Mormon, right? It's just the, you know, Mormons are a smaller part of the world's population when it comes to that religion. And so I think it's going to get more diluted as time goes on and as, you know, things spread out. So that's kind of where the religion sits right now. We'll see how it looks in the future. Let's talk a little bit about jobs. So in Salt Lake County, you're going to find a good mixture of blue collar and white collar jobs. In the Northwest quadrant, you're going to find a lot of manufacturing and shipping and transportation jobs. This is where a lot of the blue collar jobs are at. In the downtown area, you're going to find a lot of banking, finance, that type of industry, you know, typically your white collar in the downtown area. And then as you get out into the rest of the county, of course, there's just a huge mixture. There's a ton of office and administration jobs. There's a lot of construction jobs. There's a lot of food service and hotel workers. There's just a whole mixture of jobs in the rest of the county. Talking about Utah County, you're going to find the same mixture, right? You always have food workers, hotel workers, office administrators, whatever. You always have those jobs pretty much no matter where you go. But in Utah County specifically, you're going to find a lot higher percentage of white collar workers, in my opinion. You're going to find a lot of tech workers here, and you're going to find a lot of people who work in the healthcare space as well. All right, now the good one. Let's talk a little bit about home prices. This is probably the thing that's most concerning to you if you're thinking about making a move here is, well, where am I going to live on a day-to-day basis? In Salt Lake County, for single family homes, you're looking at a median price of just over $400,000. You're looking at average days on market between 1 and 2 weeks. Your typical home is going to be a 4-bedroom, 3-bath, roughly 2,400 square feet. And these homes are usually selling for roughly $165 per square foot. Of course, if you have a smaller home, it's going to sell for a higher per square foot number. But if you have a bigger home, it's actually going to sell for less money per square foot. Talking a little bit about condos and townhomes, your average price in Salt Lake County is going to be about $290,000. Your average home will be roughly 1,500 square feet, 3-bedroom, 3-bath, and it's going to sell for close to $190 per square foot. You're going to see that these homes typically also sit on the market for between 1 and 2 weeks. That doesn't mean that things aren't moving quicker than that, though. I've seen numerous homes recently where they're flying off the shelf in just a couple of days. You do just have those outliers, you know, that will sit on the market for 2, 3, 4 months because they're just overpriced, which does increase that number overall. So the homes that are priced right and in a good neighborhood and in good shape are selling generally within a week or less. All right, let's talk about Utah County. Utah County single family homes are going to be a little bit lower. You're looking at about $380,000. Days on market is going to be a little bit longer, between 2 and 3 weeks typically. You'll also find 4-bedroom, 3-bath homes on average here. And your median home size is about 2,800 square feet and sells for roughly $138 per square foot. Condos and townhomes in Utah County is going to be roughly $270,000 for the median price. 3 bedrooms, 3 baths, roughly 1,700 square feet, and typically on the market for anywhere from 2 to 3 weeks. Now, the thing that's interesting about this, and you may find this interesting as well, when you look at this data on this, homes and condos and townhomes in Utah County are typically cheaper, but they're also bigger on average. I think this is because they're relatively new compared to a lot of the older homes in Salt Lake that were just built smaller and have, you know, appreciated more over time, that are more expensive there, but you'll find bigger homes and for cheaper in Utah County. So if you're looking for the best bang for your buck, Utah County might be an option for that. I'm not saying you can't find a good deal in Salt Lake County, but just something to consider. Let's talk quickly about rents. If we're looking at apartments, a 2-bedroom in Salt Lake is going to rent for roughly $1,075 per month, and a 3-bedroom will rent for just over $1,500 per month. Utah County, again, it's cheaper. 2 bedrooms will rent for roughly $862, whereas a 3-bedroom is going to rent for roughly $1,200. A little bit about recreation in these areas, in these two counties. Salt Lake County, you've got better access to the Wasatch Mountains, in my opinion. You've also got better access to a lot of the lakes and reservoirs that are on the backside of the Wasatch Front. So this is where you're going to have a lot easier access to get to, you know, to go boating, to go fishing, to go swimming, to go, you know, just play in the water. It's also easier to get out of the heat in the summer, and it's easier to get to the ski resorts. This is where most of the ski resorts are. So if you're a big skier or you love to go climbing, or you want to go play on these lakes, Salt Lake County might be a better option for you. That's not to say that Utah County doesn't have its pros over Salt Lake County. If you're in Utah County, especially in the south, on the western side, you're going to have easier access to the desert, which is a great place to go ride ATVs, a great place to go and drive razors, or go shoot guns. There's a lot of access out there. It's much easier to get to out there. It's a shorter drive. So if that's more your thing, you might want to consider Utah County. All right, now before we jump into schools, which is going to be super important if you've got kids, make sure to give me a thumbs up here on the video. I really appreciate the support. And don't forget to subscribe to the channel so that you get notified when I release new videos just like this about what it's like to live in Salt Lake, in Provo, in Ogden, in Park City, or anywhere in between. Let's jump into schools. So for schools, I do want to point out that Utah County does typically rank higher. Alpine School District, which covers most of the northern part of Utah County, does have one of the best rankings in the state. With the information I'm pulling this from, they're ranked number 5 in the state. They have over 86 schools and they have over 75,000 total students. Besides that, you've got Provo City School District, which is ranked 9, and you've got Nebo School District, which is ranked number 15. The schools here are typically going to be better, and they've got a lot of great sports programs, arts programs, and even stuff for science, math, etc. You've got great access to that in Utah County. Salt Lake County, you've also got special schools that do have access to great programs, great, you know, whether it's sports, whether it's arts, whether it's math, science, something like that. You do have access to those types of schools as well, but the rankings on these schools are not quite as good as you're going to find in Utah County. Starting off our list, you've got Canyon School District, which is ranked number 8, and you've got Jordan School District, ranked number 14. These cover kind of the southeast part of Salt Lake County. Beyond that, you have Murray School District, which ranks number 23, Salt Lake City School District, ranked number 29, and Granite School District, ranked 35. So if you are trying to move to an area with good schools, you want to make sure to stay towards the southern end of Salt Lake County. You're going to find the better schools here. You're going to have better access to different things like arts or sports or the math and engineering programs. Those types of things, you're going to find better access to that if you stay in the Jordan School District and the Canyon School District. So guys, with that being said, thank you so much for watching. I hope this was a good overview of the different between Salt Lake County and Utah County. I hope you enjoyed this. If you did, give me a thumbs up. Make sure to subscribe to the channel and don't forget to get in touch with me if you're making a move here to Salt Lake. I want to hear from you. I want to know what your upcoming move looks like and how I can help you with that move. I'm so excited for that. Can't wait to hear from you guys. I'll catch you in the next one.